Emsland, Isar II, and Neckarwestheim II are the last three nuclear power plants that Germany closed for good in April 2023. This ended the era of Germany as one of the most potent atomic energy producer countries, which, at the beginning of the millennia, produced a third of Germany's total electricity. The Great German Nuclear Phase-Out is deemed a detrimental move by many experts. So watch this video till the end to learn how the nuclear exodus affected the German energy sector, economy, geopolitics, and military. First, a little bit of history. Germany's foray into nuclear energy began in the 1950s, when the federal R&D programs were initiated, costing over 15.3 billion euros. Interestingly, this was 10 years after the first commercial reactors in the US were put online. However, German producers quickly caught up with world market standards, and between 1968 and 1989, 24,000 megawatts of nuclear capacity were installed. This was less than the 50,000 megawatt capacity projected in official expansion plans. The global trend saw a nearly stagnating demand for electricity and overcapacity, which led to controversy over the use of nuclear energy. This, among other reasons, prevented further expansion soon after establishing the industry. 1 year after the last, orders for new nuclear plants were placed in 1975. The controversy over the use of atomic energy had grown significantly. As a result, it became increasingly challenging to justify further expansion of the industry. During the 1970s, in Germany, several local initiatives were formed to protest against the construction of nuclear power stations. The anti-nuclear movements gained momentum as they received support from various parties nationwide. Demonstrations, rallies, and legal challenges continued growing as people opposed every new project that aimed to harness nuclear energy. One of the significant events in the movement's history was the occupation of a construction site in Wil, Baden-Württemberg, by 28,000 protesters in 1975, which resulted in the project's halting. In 1979, after the Three Mile Island nuclear accident in the United States, around 200,000 people marched in Hanover and Bonn, calling for an end to the use of nuclear power. The opposition continued to grow, and protests erupted whenever a site for radioactive waste processing and storage was proposed. The anti-nuclear movement was vital in forming the Green Party in 1980. The Chernobyl nuclear disaster in April 1986 in Ukraine further fueled the anti-nuclear sentiment in Germany.
There's been a nuclear accident near the Soviet Union at
Chernobyl's reactor 4, the scene of the total meltdown.
That explosion at a nuclear plant in the Soviet Union.
Nuclear reactor in Ukraine's Chernobyl power plant.
The event caused widespread fear among the public, and a majority of Germans became increasingly concerned about the risks associated with nuclear technology. As a result, politicians began to acknowledge that nuclear power was not the future, and that it would find alternative solutions to meet the country's energy needs. Since 1989, no new commercial nuclear power stations have been built in Germany. And the Daiichi nuclear power plant disaster in Fukushima, Japan in 2011 was the final nail in the coffin of the German atomic industry, as it gave the silver bullet of an argument to the proponents of anti-nuclear plans. Thus, Germany's energy industry has changed. The country became heavily dependent on domestic coal production and nuclear gas imports, and invested billions in green energy. Germany's primary source of domestic fossil fuel is coal, with lignite or brown coal being the most commonly extracted form. Despite the decrease in consumption of coal in recent years, there has been a rebound in 2021 and 2022 due to unfavorable weather conditions for renewables and high gas prices. Additionally, the government made efforts to replace gas use in power production with coal plants. Lignite is extracted from open cast mines on a large scale, producing 126.26 million tons in 2021, while imports remain very low. Germany has extensive lignite deposits and was once the world's largest producer, emitting exceptionally high levels of CO2. Lignite is primarily used for power generation, accounting for 20.4% of Germany's gross electricity production in 2022, and for district heating. In August of this year, Germany's cabinet made a significant commitment to invest in green initiatives by earmarking a whopping 57.6 billion euros. This figure is up by 60.2% compared to the 2023 target, and is aimed at helping the country become net zero by 2045. The Climate Transformation Fund will receive the lion's share of this investment. Of this fund, 18.9 billion euros will be allocated to the building sector for renovations and new constructions in 2024. In addition, 12.6 billion euros will be designated for renewable energy subsidies, while 4.7 billion euros will be used to expand the country's e-mobility charging infrastructure. Another crucial aspect of this investment is Germany's aim to reduce its reliance on Chinese imports. The country plans to develop local production capacity for raw materials and transformation technology, such as solar power components, to achieve this. This will be done through 4.1 billion euros worth of subsidies in the upcoming year. This investment is especially critical because the United States has introduced generous subsidies through its Inflation Reduction Act, which could lure manufacturers away from Europe. Therefore, supporting renewable energy production in Europe has become more urgent than ever before. According to the sector's regulator, the share of renewable energy on Germany's power grids witnessed a significant increase of 6.6 percentage points, reaching 55% of the total energy mix last year. This boost is a remarkable achievement for Europe's largest economy, which aims to significantly increase the proportion of green energy in its energy mix. Germany seeks to achieve 80% of its energy from renewable sources by 2030. However, as with almost everything in life, the decision to end nuclear power has severe costs for the German economy. A study by the University of Berkeley measured the difference between the observed trajectory and the alternative scenario in which the nuclear reactors would not have been shut down early. It assesses the costs associated with the more intensive use of conventional thermal power plants and the increased imports resulting from the nuclear phase-out. The authors analyzed the shutdown of 10 reactors between 2011 and 2017. The closure of nuclear power plants resulted in an additional 12% for each of the emissions. The additional CO2 emissions amounted to 36 million tons per year, representing an additional cost of 1.8 billion US dollars annually. But the most critical effects come from the additional local pollution. It would have caused an excess mortality of 1,100 individuals yearly. Taking a value of $7.9 million as the price of a German's life, the authors of the study estimate that the additional cost of the closure decision due to local pollution amounts to $8.7 billion per year. And according to a 2022 paper in the Journal of the European Economic Association, Germany will lose 3 to 8 billion euros yearly due to the nuclear power phase-out. Geopolitically, Germany has put itself in a very precarious situation. As the EU agreed to limit the import of Russian energy resources, Germany needed to dramatically decrease the import of Russian natural gas. The task was not trivial, as Berlin had to find alternative suppliers to replace tens of billions of natural gas imports from Russia. Moreover, Germany imported a substantial share of Russian oil and coal. Among the EU members, Germany was mainly dependent on Russian imports, which in 2021 accounted for 55% of its gas supply, 35% of its oil, and 45% of its coal. This fact made many countries in the EU and political analysts question Russia's influence over Germany. Berlin had to make swift changes to its Ostpolitik. The German government's approach of cooperative Ostpolitik, which aimed to bring about positive change through reconciliation and economic interdependence, had been deemed a failure due to recent developments. Specifically, since Vladimir Putin decided to invade Ukraine on February 24, 2022, the country has increasingly run afoul of German and EU interests, making it a strategic adversary. In light of these developments, Germany must revisit and reevaluate its foreign and security policies, with a renewed focus on deterrence and defense capabilities, as a core component of its approach to safeguarding its national interests and security. Plus, now Germany has to say goodbye to becoming an energy hub for Europe. In 2021, Germany launched a nationwide gas market trading hub, Trading Hub Europe, which merges its two existing hubs to boost liquidity and simplify administration. Gaspool and NetConnect Germany, or NCG, have renamed their order books to the Continuing Spot and Futures Trading. It covers over 40,000 kilometers of high-pressure pipes, connecting over 700 distribution networks in Germany, Europe's largest gas consumer and importer. Previously, Gaspool and NCG operated in separate regions, essentially creating two gas markets in Germany. But now, with both Russian gas supplies through Nord Stream and Nord Stream 2, with the latter being sabotaged, Germany won't find itself in the near future in the same position it had before the war in Ukraine. Lastly, Germany's reluctance to increase military capabilities since the Second World War affected the nuclear phase-out decision. Since the time of Konrad Adenauer's chancellorship, when he secretly explored the possibilities of a trilateral German-French-Italian nuclear weapons program, the German public have been consistently opposed to the idea of a nuclear-armed Bundeswehr. This opposition has only grown stronger over the years. In 2017, according to recent polls, 93% of Germans were in favor of a worldwide ban on nuclear weapons, which is a clear indication of their stance on the issue. Furthermore, a majority of Germans doubt the concept of extended nuclear deterrence and are calling for the removal of all forward-deployed US short-range nuclear missiles from Germany. In fact, 85% of Germans support this demand. This public rejection of nuclear weapons, nuclear deterrence, and civil nuclear energy is a significant obstacle to any potential German nuclear weapons program. Even if the federal government were to decide in the future that the security situation required them to pursue a nuclear weapons option, the public's opposition would pose a formidable challenge that could not be easily surmounted. In the end, Germany has firmly decided to cut ties with nuclear energy, and only time will show whether the plan to put a country on alternative energy rails succeeds.